Hey, Big Dreamers, this is Sophia Cartman here. I just wanted to pop in and let you know I am going on a fun vacation and heading to camp. I'll be collecting awesome new stories, finding cool inspiration, and learning new things to share with you. While I'm off on my adventure, I can't report any podcasts. So enjoy a rebroadcast from Eva's and yours favorite episodes. I can't wait to come back and tell you all about my amazing experiences. Thank you so much for understanding. Stay curious and keep dreaming big.
Welcome to the Dream Big Podcast Show. We're inspiring you to shoot for the moon, take aim and go. We bring to you amazing guests who truly love what they do. Every day they're living their dreams, and so can you. Dream big, take action to reach your goals. Are you pumped yet? It's showtime, let's rock and roll.
Hi, it's Eva Cartman. And you're listening to the Dream Big Podcast Show, the place to go to learn, laugh, and grow. Today's guest is one of the most famous guests we've had on the podcast. He's also one of my favorite authors, and I'm sure many of you big dreamers love his work too. Chris Colfer. Chris rose to fame as a Golden Globe winning actor, best known for his role as Kurt Hummel on Glee. But to me, Chris is the author of one of my favorite book series, The Land of Stories. I have read all of the books in the series and loved them. So I was beyond thrilled when Chris agreed to come on the podcast. And as you'll hear, he was super nice, gracious with his time, and has tons of amazing advice for you big dreamers. And later that same evening, we found out that Chris was on The Tonight Show with Jimmy Fallon. Very cool, right? Okay, I'm sure at this point you can't wait any longer to hear this interview, so let's roll the tape. Hi, Chris. I'm so excited to have you on the Dream Big Podcast.
Oh, I'm so excited to be on your podcast. Thanks for asking me.
I absolutely love your Land of Stories series, so it's a thrill to be able to actually talk to you. But before we get into your writing and current projects, can you share a little bit about your childhood? Like, where'd you grow up? And when did you first discover your love of books?
Oh, well, I grew up in Clovis, California, which is a small suburb of Fresno, California, right in the middle of the state of California. It's a very farming type community. I was about, I'd say probably 7 or 8 years old when I first started writing The Land of Stories. And it was very, very difficult to write a book when I was about 7 because I didn't know many words to write with. But I promised myself that if I ever had the opportunity to get it published, that I would. So about 10 years later, I got cast on a big television show called Glee. And I had a lot of offers to do autobiographies or books where I talked about my life and whatnot. But I decided to do the children's book, the Land Story series, so I could fulfill that promise I made to myself. And I published the first book in 2012, and now it's been a big hit, and a lot of kids and a lot of families love it.
Wow, that's definitely a theme of our show. It's never too early to dream big, right?
That's a great way to put it. Absolutely.
What advice do you have for our big dreamers who are dreaming of becoming an author one day?
Oh, that's a very good question. I would say if you want to be an author or a writer one day, to start writing down your ideas now as a little kid, because I think as you get older, we kind of lose a little bit of our creativity and we lose a little bit of our imagination. So if we hold on to the stories that we think are entertaining as kids, then other kids will enjoy them if you get the chance to get them published.
Are there certain elements you think are very important in a book?
I think, yes, I think humor is a very, very important thing to have in a book, because if your book doesn't have if your book doesn't make your readers smile or laugh, I think they'll be less likely to be invested in it. So I would recommend putting as much humor and heart also into your story as you can.
Can you share a bit about your writing process? Like, where do you find the inspiration when you write new stories?
You know, inspiration will hit me at random times. Like sometimes I'll be at the grocery store, or I'll be at the gas station, and an idea will pop into my head, and I'll have to immediately go home and write it down, or write it down in the notes on my phone. My process is kind of crazy. I tend to kind of disappear from life when I write. I lock myself in my office at home. And I write all day and write all night. Usually do that for a couple months until I get the book done. But I love diving into it head first and really just immersing myself in the whole experience.
Do you feel like you're still improving as a writer?
Oh, yes. I think I'm always improving as a writer. Yes. And I think everyone should always be improving. It's really hard to write something that you think is perfect. You're always going to look back on something you write with new ideas and new ways that you want to tell the story. I think it's important for people to grow as writers. I think even the biggest writers, you know, will say they'll look back at the first thing they wrote and wish they could change it.
See, big dreamers, even people who have found great success like Chris has with his books are always trying to get better and better. So, Chris, I wanted to ask you a few specific questions about your new book, The Land of Stories, The Ultimate Book Hugger's Guide. And your agent sent us a copy, which I received on Friday and did not put down until I finished it. Can you explain what the book is about?
Oh, wonderful. Yes, The Land of Stories, The Ultimate Book Hugger's Guide is... it's a lot of things. It acts like an encyclopedia for the Land of Stories series. So it tells you all about the characters and the places that the book takes place in, or the series takes place in. We also have a lot of fan art from readers around the world included in it. We have a lot of stuff, things that I wrote about how the whole series came to me and what inspired me to make the different characters and what inspired me to describe the locations the way that I did. So if you are a fan of the series, I think you will love this book because it tells you everything you would ever want to know about the series and how it was made.
You know, I really loved it because it gave me background on some of my favorite characters and places and sketches for the covers and the original sketch that started it all.
Yeah, there's a sketch in there that I drew when I was about 7 years old. And it was the first image that I ever created of the Land of Stories. So you'll get to see that if you get the book.
Okay, big dreamers, I encourage you to get a copy. You can find it on Amazon, local bookstores, and of course, we will include a link in our show notes. So I also heard that The Land of Stories, The Wishing Spell, is being made into a movie and that you're writing the screenplay and will direct. How excited are you to take what you have written and turn it into a movie?
I am so excited. Words cannot describe how excited I am. And we've been working really, really hard to really bring the story to life and make sure that all the readers are happy with it. And I cannot wait for you guys to see it because I think you guys are going to love it. And I'm so looking forward to seeing all these characters and all these places come to life.
You know, my other favorite series is Harry Potter, and it was really amazing to see how Hollywood was able to make the magical wizarding world come to life. So I can't wait to see what you and your team come up with, because for some parts of the book series, for instance, when Alex and Connor fall into the book to get to the Land of Stories, it's really hard to imagine how you can pull that off in a film. I can't wait.
Oh, good. I think you're going to really like what we've come up with.
I'm sure I am. And I know from reading your biography that you struggled in middle school and high school with bullying. And a lot of the big dreamers in our audience are that age. And I'm sure your success will be very inspiring to them. Because when you are being bullied, you often feel helpless. What advice do you give to the big dreamers out there who are being bullied?
Well, I think my best advice for anyone who's being bullied out there is to know that one day it's going to be over. You're going to get older and people are going to become more mature, and it's just not going to happen anymore. So you might be feeling really stuck, and you might feel like this kind of harassment that you're getting is going to last forever, but it will not. Because people change, they get older, they get wiser, and you're also going to get to a point where people can say whatever they want to about you, and you're just not going to care. And that's been my favorite part about getting older, is the older I get, the less and less I care about what people say or do or think of me. And it's very, very freeing. And so you have that to look forward to, the days when you just don't care anymore, and it's not part of your life anymore.
Yeah, big dreamers, if anyone is ever physical with you, then you should report that to an adult immediately. And as Chris said, know that it's going to be over in the future. But for bullies that are not being violent, but are just saying mean things about how you look or your style and the way you dress, just ignore them and realize that those people are deeply unhappy with their own lives and it has nothing to do with you. Right, Chris?
Yes.
So one of the famous quotes from the Land of Stories is, courage is one thing that no one can take away from you. And the bullies can never take away your courage, right?
Right. No, courage is something that is inside all of us. And it's something that can never, ever be taken away. And that goes for compassion and logic, too. And I think someone who values those values are going to be so much better off in life than someone who doesn't.
Thank you. And I have a few more questions for you. I heard that you're an animal lover, and do you have a favorite kind of animal?
Oh my gosh, I love all kinds of animals. I have two dogs right now. Their names are Cooper and Fitzgerald. Cooper is a golden retriever, and he's a little fool of himself. And Fitzgerald is a Havanese corgi mix, and he's hilarious because he's very easily stressed out. And he likes to herd me around the house. But I love animals. I think my favorite animal though are llamas. I've always thought llamas are really cool.
That's great. What is your favorite thing to do when you're not working?
Oh gosh, I love to eat. That's probably my favorite thing to do. I love to travel. I love to read. I think reading is very, very important, for writers and any young writers out there. One of my tips would be to read as much as you possibly can, because the more you read, the better you'll be able to write.
You know, I love to read too. Like, you could mostly find me during the day just having a book in my hand while doing something with my other hand, just reading and reading and reading.
Oh, good, good.
Yeah. But sometimes, no matter how creative you are, you get stuck as a writer. And I believe that's called writer's block. When you have a case of writer's block, how do you push past it?
Oh, very good question, because writer's block affects everyone. My best advice for anyone who has writer's block is to just get up and walk away from writing the minute that you feel it coming. Because the more you sit and you stress over it and you think about it and you worry about it, the worse and worse and worse it's going to get. So I would say just stop what you're writing when you feel writer's block coming on, and go do something else. Go see a movie, go listen to music, go read a book, go take a walk, take a bike ride, just do something else and wait for the inspiration to come back, because it will. But the longer you kind of stress out and hover over something you're writing, the worse the writer's block is going to get.
If you go back in time and talk to your 8-year-old self, what would be the best advice?
Oh my gosh, that's such a good question. I would tell him just to take a deep breath, because I was always so worried when I was a kid that I wasn't going to become a writer, or maybe that I wasn't going to be able to be in a TV or a movie. I was just worried all the time. So I would tell him just to take a deep breath and stop worrying, and know that that life was going to work itself out.
When you have doubted yourself in the past, what made you overcome those fears and continue to go on with your dream?
Oh, it's a very good question. Well, you know, honestly, I think I was just lucky enough to have a wonderful dream. What I'm doing right now, I'm turning The Land Stories, my first book, into a movie, and it's going to be the first movie that I direct. And that has always been my biggest dream, to be able to bring my characters and my stories to life. And that dream, I think, has really been what has guided me and shaped me throughout my life. So I think my advice for anyone listening is just to make sure that they have some kind of goal, something that makes life all worth it to them. And then to pursue that as much as you possibly can, and let it be kind of like your North Star and guide you through life.
That's an amazing dream. I would personally add that one of my big dreams for you is that the Land of Stories becomes a world at Disneyland, sort of like the Harry Potter world at Universal Studios, where kids and adults can go and explore the Land of Stories and go on rides. That would be so much fun, because right now I'm envisioning a roller coaster where you go up and then you drop inside a giant book.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I love that. That would be amazing. I would love for the Land Stories to become a land at Disneyland. That's a very good idea.
Okay. I have one more question for you. Where can our audience find out more about you?
Oh, it's a very good question. Well, I think if you go to, thelandofstories.com, you'll find a lot of information about me, and my books, and where you can get my books, and upcoming books. So I think, yeah, I think the Land of Stories website is probably the best place to go.
Okay, thank you, Chris, for coming on the Dream Big podcast.
Oh, thank you so much for having me. You're so lovely.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.
That was so much fun. Thank you so much, Chris, for taking the time out of your very busy schedule to come on the show. Big Dreamers, be sure to check out Chris's new book, The Land of Stories, The Ultimate Book Hugger's Guide. And of course, keep an eye for the Land of Stories movie, which I already can't wait to see. Did you enjoy this special episode? If so, please tell your friends and family about the Dream Big podcast. If everyone listening can just tell one person about this episode, that would lead to a chain reaction that would get the Dream Big podcast in front of so many new people, which would be amazing. If you haven't already, be sure to hit the subscribe button so you can be notified whenever we release a new episode. Thank you so much for tuning in. This is Eva Cartman reminding you that you have unlimited potential. Your dreams are not optional. You need to make them essential. So take massive action to turn those big dreams into reality. Live with passion, the way life is meant to be. I'll see you next episode. Bye.